Hey guys, I'm back. Today I am going to test out like a bunch of new products that I bought. Some of them are from the drugstore, some of them are from other places, and some of them I actually had sent to me from the brands. So we're just gonna like go through and test them out, and it's gonna be like a get ready with me slash first impressions slash what did I buy. So stay tuned and keep watching. All right, so I already like prepped my face. I used the Skindinavia setting spray primer, and then I used another primer over top of it to like simplify and like make my pores look a lot smaller. So I've already done that, and that's pretty much all I've done so far. So I just got this Revlon Photo Ready makeup, and it was on sale at the drugstore for like half off because they're, I guess, like getting rid of this line, or they're going to be getting a new line in. I'm not quite sure, but it says Revlon Photo Ready, and I got mine in the shade, the lightest shade. It was like the only one that they had, and it's Ivory. So I'm hoping it's not like tuper light for me. And tuper is a word I just made it up. So let me try this. I'm gonna put it on with my beauty blender. I've heard a lot of good stuff about this foundation, so we'll see how this goes. My beauty blender smells wonky. This is like a lot of coverage. I probably should have taken that into consideration. I vaguely remember hearing that it was a lot of coverage. So I'm hoping, because I'm putting it on with my beauty blender, that it'll kind of mute it a little bit. I do kind of want a little more coverage right now though, because my skin is acting really crazy. And I'm just like patting, like, and dabbing and like pushing it around and into my skin instead of like swiping it. You're gonna like pat it into the skin. The only places I kind of swipe it is where I want to like sheer out the coverage a little bit. Oh, my eyes! I like this foundation. It is a higher coverage, which is kind of what I wanted. The color is not too light. So this, I do like it. I'm gonna see how it wears today. I think we found a winner. Okay, what else are we doing? I'm gonna do my concealer. And I am using the Mac Pro Longwear, and I think I'm... Yeah?
What you doing?
Filming?
Selfies?
No, I'm not taking selfies. This is NW20, and I just put it on my hand, and then I use my finger to put it on my face. I am going to use my beauty blender to like sheer it out a little bit, because this concealer is very concealing. Get my eyebrows waxed. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set this, and I am using this Dream Wonder Powder from Maybelline, and I got the color Porcelain Ivory. This is new, I have never tried it before. And I'm just using a ITCosmetics airbrush blurring brush, And I'm just kind of like packing, or not packing, but just stippling it in. I hope this doesn't look too cakey when I'm done, because I feel like I'm doing a lot. I normally never do this much. So, there's that. The next thing we're going to do is I'm going to put on my blush, my bronzer, and all that stuff to kind of do some contouring. I'm using this Elizabeth Arden bronzing powder in Deep Glow. And it's from their Pure Finish Summer Escapes collection. It's kind of dark for me, so I just put a little on my Real Techniques blushing brush, and I just kind of like do a little bit of contouring, but not too harshly. Okay, so we're just gonna like start here, because on my cheekbones you can kind of see, like right here is my cheekbone and you can feel it. So if you start going down your face, a little area where it starts to hollow in, that is where you should put your contour color, the darker color. So mine, for me, it's like right about here. And then we kind of go back into the hairline a little bit. See how I did that? So you're gonna put a little bit more on the brush, and then you're gonna continue up the side of your face. So I'm gonna do the same thing again and then keep going, because this is not like deep enough for me. And you always wanna go like with your contour, you always want to go up. You don't want to go down and then down, because then it kind of brings your face down. So I kind of go back and forth here, and then I go up like that. And then it gets all in my hair, and my hair gets crazy. But that's why I just kind of have like a messy bun today. I don't have really anything going on. You see the difference in this side of my face and this side of my face? It helps. So we're gonna do the same thing over here. And it's gonna be essentially the same motions. So you're gonna find your area, right? For me, it's like right about here. You're gonna start and go up. And then I kind of go you like around the cheekbone. It's easier for me to show you on this side, because this side, it's the left side of my face, and I'm right-handed and it's a mess. So you're gonna kind of go up and around your cheekbone. You know what I mean? And I'm doing all this with like the finishing touch areas. I didn't put any new product on the brush. I'm just kind of using whatever's left, and there isn't much. So at this point, I'm just kind of blending it all out. I'm trying to bring down this a little farther towards my lips, because my face is super round and I don't want it to be looking so round, especially since I have my hair up. So I'm just kind of taking it and pulling it a little bit towards my lips. Not too far, because you don't want to look like you have a beard. This is turning into a contouring video. This is not what this is supposed to be, okay? My blush, and this is the Mood Exposure blush. This is from Hourglass. I'm in love with all of these Hourglass blushes. But this is Mood Exposure. beautiful colors in there. It's more of a dark plummy color, but it's not dark at all. Okay, so for this, I am gonna kind of put it a little bit on my apples, but I don't want to go too far, and I'm not gonna do that whole smile thing. Don't do that. Never do that. Okay, I don't know who made that up. It's not right. You should never do that, because when you stop smiling, the areas where you were smiling have now dropped, and it kind of like brings your face down, and that's not flattering for anybody. So you're not gonna smile. You're gonna look at the areas easier for me because I'm chubby. But the area where it's like the fullest part of your cheek, where you can see like it's kind of bulging out a little bit, that's where you're gonna put it. And then you're gonna go backwards. So I'm just gonna dab a little bit here, and then I'm gonna bring it back like that. See what I mean? This one is a little bit darker on this side. Maybe it's just me. Yeah, it's just me. Now we're using a highlight, and I normally use different brushes for all this, and I didn't bring all my brushes in here, so we're gonna have to make do. This is Opal. This is by BECCA. This is another absolutely gorgeous color, and I don't know if it's gonna... So pretty. It is so pretty. So I usually use like a fan brush for this, but it's fine. So I'm just gonna dab a little bit on the end of this blush brush, and I'm gonna start here, not here. So I'm gonna start right here, and then I kind of go up along the top of my eyebrow, because I kind of want, because my face is so round, I kind of want this area to come forward a little bit, and then a little bit here. We're gonna go down the bridge of our nose, and we're gonna put a little bit on the cupid's bow. I feel like I'm really quiet when I do this, and everybody else is always talking and like saying a lot of stuff, and I'm too quiet, I guess. Okay, we're gonna curl the lashes. Curl the lashes. This is an old eyelash curler from Revlon, and I really want the shoe Imora. How do you say that? However you say that person's name, that's the one that I want. And in case you haven't noticed, my eye is kind of big, so I have to kind of like curl in three sections, otherwise I can't get all my lashes. So that's kind of what I'm doing right now. And I'm trying not to pull them out, because I do that a lot. Stupid Kohl's. Quit trying to get me in debt. Okay. So I'm using my new Eyeco mascara. I just bought this. I purchased this on HSN. No, Amazon. I got this on Amazon. And I really wanted it, because everybody's talking about it, and I really wanted it. So this is new. That's another thing I probably should have told you. This was new that I just got. So this is like the first impression of this powder. It looks a little cakey to me, but that's because I don't normally use powder. And if I do, it's bare minerals. This is new, the foundation. I do like this so far. And then the Eyeco mascara was new. My beauty blender I've had for a while. My Pro Longwear concealer I've had forever. The Elizabeth Arden, Hourglass, and BECCA stuff that I just put on my face. These I've all had for a while. Okay, so we should probably clarify that. Oh, and this is not new, but this is new. It's newer. I haven't used it too much yet. I've only used it like since like Christmas time, so a couple weeks. So I've been testing that out. All right, so I'm gonna put on this Black Magic mascara. This is for Drama and Curl. This is by Eyeco. I will show you the tube. Good stuff. And I'm going to put this on my lashes. As opposed to not on your lashes, and I don't know where else where you put mascara, but. Well. So far, I like it. I'm not thinking that it is worth $24 though. I feel like I have other mascaras that make my eyelashes look a lot fuller, longer, more volumized. This one, you know, it says for Drama and Curl. Conditioning it, paraben-free formula, it has keratin and shea butter. So maybe this is a little bit better for your lashes. But for what I wanted to do, I'm thinking that this is not worth $24. $24, I mean, that's a lot of money. Especially for a baller and a budget, that's a lot of money. $24. Keep that in mind when we're doing this. I mean, even some of the Dior mascaras are not even $24, as far as I know. Like with the Dior mascaras, I feel like some of them are like in the $18-$20 range. I mean, I could be wrong. But I'm thinking $24 is a lot for a mascara. It seems to be fast drying, because when I'm doing the second coat, it's already, the first coat's kind of like, you know, when it's like hard to kind of go through, so you like put it in, you're like, you know what I mean? You know that feeling. Oh, look at that. I know you can see that on my eyelid. The best trick is, because I get mascara like everywhere when I do mascara, the best trick is to like wait, let it dry, get a Q-tip, and then just kind of clean it off. So before I step out the house is when I'm going to do that, so y'all are going to have to watch me like this forever. Keeping it real with you guys. I don't know if you can see me if I do this. So the verdict on the mascara, I'm going to wear it a little bit to kind of like see how I feel. But the verdict is it's a little clumpy. Let me try and do it this way. It's a little clumpy. It's a little messy and hard to deal with. I like the formula. It does seem very lengthening, but it's not really, super volumizing. We'll see if it has any kind of like curling effects, because that's the whole thing. It says Drama and Curl. So I don't hate it. It's not like one of those ones that I've like put it on and I'm like, oh no, but it's definitely not my favorite mascara. My favorite mascara right now is the Bare Minerals mascara, but a friend of mine sent me this like unique one that has like the fibers and stuff in it. I definitely need to try that out. So when I try that one, I'll let you guys know about that because that's been on my list of things to try. So listen, this is another new thing that I got. This I actually got sent to me from OCC, and it's OCC is Obsessive Compulsive Cosmetics, and they sent me a bunch of like lip liners and lip tars and some pigments, things like that. So I'm super excited to try this. This is the color Lydia, and it seems like it's gonna be like that, like Chloe, what's her name? The Kardashian chick, Kylie Jenner. It seems like it might be a little bit kind of like that color. So I'm gonna try this. And I have used the lip tars before, but I've never used the liner. So I'm really excited to try the liner. And it's very pretty. It is a pencil one. It's a pencil liner. So when you take it out, I mean, it's a pencil form. I love how they smell. They smell like pencil. Like 2%, like, you know, 2% milk. What? You'll get to watch me line my very small lips now. Okay, my lips are all lined. Sorta. I take forever to line my lips because they're a little small, so I kind of like draw outside the lines a teeny tiny bit. And then I can tell you that for this being like a pencil form, this is super creamy. I have no idea where this stopped recording it. This is really nice. For this being a pencil form, usually the pencils are like a little more like not as creamy, but this is amazing. I love it. Lip tar in Lydia as well, and this is in the matte finish. So what I'm going to do with this is put some on my hand. And I'm going to use the brush that comes with it. Oh, this is gorgeous. This is so pretty. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. This is the prettiest color I've ever used. So pretty. Done because of their consistency and with how my lips are, I just don't want to screw it up, so I do take a little bit longer to put it on, but this is so freaking pretty. I'm gonna clean that brush later. This is amazing. Okay, I'm gonna see how this stuff wears, and then I'm going to also like let you know in a blog post how I liked it. I'm gonna take some pictures throughout the day to kind of refresh. And yeah, so I really appreciate you watching my new videos this year, and stay tuned to my channel. Please subscribe if you like the video, and comment below about something else you guys might want to see. I've bought a lot of new products lately. Some stuff has been sent to me, but a lot of stuff I have purchased with my own money. So you know, let me know what you guys want to see, you know, if you want to see any more new stuff from the drugstore or whatever. I don't know if it's necessarily going to be like new at the drugstore, or if it's going to be like new to Michelle from the drugstore, stuff like that. So I will see you guys later. I hope you have a great week and stay tuned. Bye. Does it look funny?
What is it?
the place of where I put the camera.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity. You know the roof on fire.
We go
That's my piercing, do you find it?
Oh, isn't it in your, in that thing? Next to the bed? It's not in there? Can you take all your rings out? No?
I look.
Okay. Okay, I'll look for it later. It's a very, oh my god, what is that?